Hello and welcome to Proxmox Tutorials. In this video, I'm going to show you how the new Import Wizard for VMware ESXi Virtual Machines works. First, we're going to establish the connection to the VMware ESXi host. To do this, we mount the host as a new Proxmox storage. If we now go to the demo ESXi storage, we can see all the VMware virtual machines that we can import. I'm initiating the import wizard for the Windows 2022 server. Proxmox VE will extract the virtual machine's configuration and propose settings for Proxmox VE, which you can then accept or modify at your discretion. For instance, you can set the CPU type to match the host system. Within the advanced settings, you can define the target storage for each disk and add the VirtIO controller. The VirtIO driver ISO can also be mounted simultaneously. I'm going to provide more details on that after the import. The boot disk remains SATA for now and can only be switched to VirtIO SCSI in a second step after the import. To conclude, you can specify the network card type, including the option to use a unique MAC address or retain the existing one. The summary displays the final configuration for the virtual machine to be imported. Then let's go. The import process naturally takes longer for large virtual disks. The importer works best with VMware 8. For older versions 7 or 6, some settings on the ESXi need to be optimized. You can find more details on that in our documentation or in the forum. Once the import is complete, you can start the imported virtual machine for an initial test. If everything is working properly, we will shut down the virtual machine, create a snapshot, and begin optimizations. Now we can shut down the VM. So everything worked fine, and we're going to take a snapshot now. To enable VirtIO booting, we need to first mount a dummy disk to the virtual machine. Additionally, we will enable the guest agent and start the VM. Once the VM is started, we will install all VirtIO drivers and shut down the VM again. Now we can shut down the VM. Now we will remove and delete the VirtIO dummy disk. Do so by first detaching it and then removing the unused disk. Then we will unmount the SATA disk and add it back as VirtIO SCSI. Remember to change the boot order to the SCSI disk. And the VM should now boot with the VirtIO drivers. The device manager displays the VirtIO disk controller, indicating that the virtual machine is now using VirtIO SCSI for its boot disk. The VirtIO network card can also be configured, even while the VM is running, using hot plug functionality. Additionally, the VirtIO serial controller and VirtIO balloon device are also installed. That's it. Thank you for watching. If you need help, check the community forum or get a support subscription.